conscience. Science without humanity. Knowledge without character. Politics without principle. Commerce without morality. And worship without sacrifice. Less sense, more knowledge, but less judgment. More experts, but less solutions. More medicines, but less wellness. We have higher income, but lower morals. These are the times of tall men and short character. These are the days of two incomes, but more divorce. These are the days of ancient houses, but broken homes. My dear students, fourth industrial revolution is going to take place. And many books, many magazines, many articles warn you that please remember automation, artificial intelligence, are going to reduce the jobs. But I have to tell you some advice. Please remember that there is no substitute for hard work. If you have a goal, please stick to it. Don't give it up. Say, never, never again. And if you see our chief guest, Venkayaji Naidu, who rose from farmer to vice president, or our governor, Koshiyarji, or Chagan Bhujbal, you will find that they have a lesson to tell you. All of them have struggled hard. All of them must have faced difficulties. And therefore, my request to you, my graduating student, is please, please remember one thing, tough times don't last, tough man lasts. My dear students, I have only one request, and which I repeat in every convocation. You have three organs of your body, brain, heart, and stomach. They are doing their physiological and biological duties. Please, please train them, train the brain to think of innovation. Something new, something which has not been even attempted by anyone. Then, compassion in heart. Can you help someone who is not as lucky as you are? Please remember that there are 6,40,000 villages in the country. Please, please, don't forget the villagers, because you and your parents. Innovation in brain, compassion in heart, and third, please train your stomach to think of passion, the fire in your belly. And if you do these three things, innovation in brain, compassion in heart, and passion in belly, whatever may be your faculty, whatever may be the difficulty, these things will always give you success, success and success. I wish you all the best.
...and different ideologies. I now request Chancellor...
...faculty members, the Board of Management, and brothers and sisters, I am really very happy to be here at with you all today in the august company of the Honorable Governor of Maharashtra and also the Honorable Minister and also two veterans who have been recognized and awarded doctorate by this prestigious university. I am here in a prestigious university, that is Symbiosys which is known across the country and outside the country for maintaining standards, values, and giving value-added education. That's why I am very happy to be here and with you all today on this very important and pious occasion. I say it's a pious occasion because you are getting graduated and you are going to enter your life, the real life. I am also happy today is a very auspicious day. Today, Gita, as was explained by earlier, Gita, this very pious day. The parliament is on, that's why I could make it today. Otherwise, we are all preoccupied with parliament. And being the not only vice president, by virtue of being vice president to be chairman of the Rajya Sabha, I have to be in parliament. And parliament, I am happy to saw Jyoti Bhai Pune, many more such people at their birth here, and they have passed the message of guidance and reform from this historic city. My dear students and faculty, we are celebrating 150th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi, and Pune has a very special connect with Mahatmaji. He was imprisoned in Yerawada jail here by the Britishers during civil disobedience movement and again during Quit India movement in 1942. This is the place where he lost two of his dearest persons, his wife Kasturba and his personal associate Sri Mahadev Deshai. Their samadhis are also located in this historic city. I bow and pay my respect to all these great men and women who laid down their lives for the cause of country's freedom. I salute their memory. On this, our history to be told to our children during a very young age itself, and they should draw inspiration from the history, from the sacrifices, from the lives of the people. Unfortunately, because of the colonial rule, our history is not properly written or properly included in the syllabus because we followed Macaulay education system. It used to be given to the students from across the globe. They used to come here and learn. I am happy today this institution led by Dr. Mazumdar is housing 85 countries. This speaks of again going back to our old heritage and culture and preeminence in education. I am happy that this institution is housing around 85 countries and the students are all studying here. Knowledge is very much available in this country. It has to be recognized, it has to be respected, and it has to be promoted, and it has to be propagated. That's the need of the hour. That's why I insist that culture and history should be part of our education system, because that is the beginning. Foundations are laid for your life. Why I am saying history is, history should be remembered. We need to preserve, promote, propagate our culture, our heritage. Sarve jana sukhino bhavantu vasudhaika kutumbakam. The entire world is one family. Share and care is the core of Indian philosophy. Share and care is the core of Indian philosophy. We must preserve that culture. We must promote that culture. We must tell our children about that culture. And we see to it that they follow this culture throughout their life. Future, your own future, our own future. We should love and live with the nature. Unfortunately, we started neglecting the nature and nature is showing its fury on us. This climate change. I want to repeat the same. What is said about the life and education. There are great sayings of these great people. Secondly, the culture is important. Today, what is culture again? Culture is respecting parents. Culture is respecting elders. Culture is respecting teachers. Culture is respecting nature. Culture is respecting fellow citizens. Culture is respecting more accessible and affordable. My dear students, the real life journey starts now. All that you have learned in this institution will provide you the basic tools for your individual and professional growth. It depends upon you, how you go on adding to this pool of knowledge. You must constantly update your knowledge and skills because the world of work is constantly changing. New skill sets become essential. New knowledge transforms old paradigms. You can and you should keep yourself ahead in this knowledge revolution. We are living in an era of LPG, liberalization, privatization, globalization. There is no way you can escape from that. That throws an opportunity, but also throws challenges. So you have to equip yourself, and our education institutions must equip the children. The tools to face these challenges and to utilize this opportunity. Let me remind you that your success will depend on a number of factors, but will essentially depend on your competence and humility to realize that there is so much to learn. This is what the ancient Indian text, Hitopadesam, has to say about an educated person. Vidya dadati vinayam, vinaya dyati patratam, patratvadvannam mapnoti, dhanadharmam tatah sukham. True education gives us humility to become lifelong learners. With constant learning, we constantly upgrade our competence. As we become more competent, we access better livelihood opportunities and acquire wealth. The education, the research must aim to make the people's life more comfortable and more happy. The ultimate aim of research is not to add degrees, but to see that the people's quality of life is enhanced and people are made to live happily. Not simply prosperity. Prosperity is okay, but prosperity coupled with must bring happiness. Happiness, that is more important. After 70 years of urbanization, massive urbanization, still 60% of the people, they live in the rural areas. You must serve the rural people and try to bridge this urban-rural divide at the earliest. I urge you, as I told you, to focus your attention on the agriculture and the rural development and the welfare of the poor and marginalized. Agriculture is our basic culture. Because she has given the beautiful birth, mother includes father also. You know woman, na? Woman, W-O. What is woman, W-O? M-A-N, man is there in woman. So nothing to worry on that count. Second is the mother tongue. The language that has come from mother's womb should always be promoted, respected. You should feel proud that you speak Marathi. You speak Telugu, Tamil, Kannada, Malayali, Marathi, Assami, Punjabi, Bhojpuri, Dogri, Urdu, whatever it is that has come from mother's womb, you should promote, protect it and propagate it, because you will be able to articulate better, you will be able to think better, you will be able to translate it better. If you have foundation in mother tongue, at home, in the bazaar, among with the friends, you must always converse in your mother tongue. The weakness should not take over. We are now developing a culture, mummy-daddy culture. Why mummy-daddy? Why not we think about our own ma? Ma, mane antaral se aata hai. Mummy, yaha se aata hai. Ek bar try karke raat mein, hostel room mein, bait ke, ek bar try karke dekh. The mother tongue is like your eyesight. The other language is like your spectacles. You understand? If you have eyesight, spectacles will work. If you have no sight, then any rubber glass also will not add to your insight or foresight. Forget about sight. Have to promote our language. Learn as many languages as possible. Nothing wrong. We must do even ye bhavana aap sab mein hona bahut zaruri hai. This is what is required. This is what is required for youngsters. We should not be carried away by caste, creed, sex, religion and region. They have their place. But as far as the country is concerned, we are all one. We should feel proud of our culture, our heritage, and our languages, and our traditions, and our country, and our forefathers. And then, should also remember always Guru. Jinhone aapko gyan diya, hamesha Guru ko, atma matter ko, hamesha yaad rakhna chahiye. My dear friends, youngsters, there is a bright future for you, bright future for our country. We should all join together and promote and protect our culture. rent, gain, return. Return back to the society, return back to parents, return back to